the Executioners, number one and two. And take your pick as to the designation of one and two. Joining forces with big 300-plus pounds of Bruiser Brody. They're going to be meeting Jay Strongbow, Billy Whitewolf, and Andre the Giant. Brody is a huge, absolutely huge man, as are the Executioners, but compared to Andre, they're a little on the small side.
Ladies and gentlemen, six-man tag team match, 3 out of 5 falls, introducing Team A. A combined weight, 575 pounds. Here are the Executioners, one and two. Their tag team partner this evening, 325 pounds, Santa Fe, New Mexico. Here is Bruiser Brody. Their tag team opponents this evening, from Ardmore, Oklahoma, 245 pounds, Indian Billy Whitewolf. From Pawhuska, Oklahoma, 260 pounds, here is Chief Jay Strongbow. And last but not least, their tag team partner tonight, 425 pounds from Grenoble in the French Alps, here is Andre the Giant. 3 out of 5 falls, Dick Kroll is your referee.
There we have the principals. We can hardly get it on our screen. There are six men, and it wouldn't surprise me if we don't have them all in the same ring at one time after the match begins during some period of this match. Havoc likely to break loose here in Madison Square Garden in this six-man match, and it appears as though Brody kind of wants to be singled out against Andre the Giant. And if that's the case, I, for one, would like to see that. Brody, world-renowned for his massive size and strength, should be quite a test against Andre the Giant. Andre, of course, really untested as far as strength is concerned, because he's just in another ballpark all by himself in another league. But if anybody can do it, just might be Bruiser Brody right here tonight. Referee Dick Kroll's going to have a bit of a problem, I would imagine, in maintaining order in the six-man match. 3 out of 5 falls, you heard it announced, 2-hour time limit. It's not likely to go 2 hours, though. Who's it gonna be, Executioner, number one, two, or whatever, maybe three or four? No telling how many there are, but tonight we see only two. Against, looks like it's gonna be Billy Whitewolf left in there. Whitewolf now. Set to tackle one of those big executioners. It's really hard to determine and appreciate the size of these wrestlers, and unless you see them in person or standing alongside yourself in street clothes or something of that nature. Whitewolf trying to maintain a bit of an advantage as he was, trouble for Billy Whitewolf. Here comes big Bruiser Brody. Brody hammering on his opponent, Billy Whitewolf, wide open there as the Executioner was holding him. And Brody just continuing to pummel away on Billy Whitewolf. Head first in a turnbuckle, and Whitewolf in a heap of trouble. Strongbow took a swipe at Bruiser Brody. But if you detract referee Dick Kroll, and on the other side of the coin, there's no telling what's going to happen with these executioners. Hair pull down to the canvas goes Billy Whitewolf, another tag. And what we are likely to see here tonight, as far as the threesome of the executioners and Brody is concerned, just about everything in the world they can do and get away with. We're going to see probably frequent tags because they are big men, and as a result, may have a tendency to run out of gas a little earlier than, say, the Strongbow or White Wolf. Double team, we're obviously seeing that as well. We'll probably see a triple team before it's all over. Andre's going to come in. Strongbow wants to come in and help out also. But referee Dick Crow is going to send him right back. And just as he sends him back, we're taking a look at a three-on-one situation. Now two-on-one. White Wolf able to hook the elbow, but the big 300-pound executioner tagging Bruiser Brody. Every year these wrestlers get more rugged and certainly get larger and more powerful. There was a time not long ago when a wrestler was considered large when he was 250 pounds, but now they've gone well over the 300-pound mark. Strongbow in the ring for the first time. Uh-oh, and he's in trouble right away. Brody, with those massive arms of his, applying the pressure on Jay Strongbow, who's in quite a bit of trouble. Strongbow trying to hammer his way out of there. Finally got away, heads for the ropes. Kick to the chest of Bruiser Brody, hard right hand, down he goes. And Strongbow finds himself right back where he was before the bear hug applied by Big Bruiser Brody. Strongbow trying to chop his way out. Headed for the ropes again. Oh, but right back in the same spot. Coming off the ropes again, Strongbow between the legs. This time goes over, and here comes Andre the Giant. Andre cleaning house. Look at this. Brody to the ropes, coming up. Oh, and things are right back around the other way. Oh, Brody trying to pull his hair out. Meanwhile, one of the executioners working on the knee of Andre the Giant. He must let go of Bruiser Brody. Brody dazed, doesn't know where he is, turns around, and look what's facing him. Strongbow, bam! There goes Strongbow again, here he comes. Caught the referee in there. And the Indians run for cover. Well, Bruiser Brody has not fared too well at all against Andre the Giant on a one-on-one situation. But now it's not one on one, it's two against one. And if Brody recovers, we're likely to see three against one. Attack made, you're trying to cripple Andre, trying to immobilize him, trying to chop him down to their size. They're only 300 pounds. That left leg of Andre the Giant, taking an awful lot of punishment. I believe they're working on the knee. Back Mater comes a fresh executioner, gets Andre the Giant. Andre kicks out. Here comes Whitewolf. Wow, what a body slam. Cover, one. Now the other executioner interrupting things for Billy Whitewolf. Action in and outside the ring, but right now is executioner in control of Billy Whitewolf. White Wolf to the ropes, coming off ready for him. The executioner kick to the chest, certainly taking its toll. What a cover. And three. So in this 3 out of 5 fall event, Billy White Wolf defeated by one of the executioners for the first fall.
Time of the first fall, 10 minutes, 50 seconds. The winners, the executioners and Bruiser Brody. First fall, 10:50.
Well, the individuals who completed the last fall must begin this fall. Which, of course, will be White Wolf, who appears to have not fully recuperated, and one of the executioners. Look what's happening here. Tag was made, the executioner coming off those ropes with a knee down into the chest. Down for the cover, referee. Oh boy. Count of two, White Wolf was able to kick out despite some interference on the part of the other executioner. Wide open Billy White Wolf and out of right field. Comes on, rather not Andre the Giant. He looks a little like Andre, he's so big, but Bruiser Brody. Brody snapping down White Wolf. Oh! And Brody caught White Wolf with that knee that'd be scraping him up off the canvas. Strong, but what a workout. Oh, look out. Tag made, White Wolf coming in. Down goes one of the executioners. Whipped to the rope. Double chop on the part of Billy Whitewolf. Down for the cover. Referee, one, two, and three. Those are the fans a little more appreciative of the situation as it exists at the moment with one fall apiece.
Ladies and gentlemen, the time of the second fall, 2 minutes, 29 seconds. Winners of the fall, Indian Billy Whitewolf, Chief Jay Strongbow, and Andre the Giant. One fall apiece.
So again, to begin the third fall, we will have Billy Whitewolf out there with one of the executioners. Here we go. 3 out of 5 fall event. This match must go at least 2 more falls. Now there is some confusion on the part of the referee as to which executioner was the last executioner in the ring. And it really would be tough to tell them apart in the heat of combat. That executioner is chewing out the referee. But White Wolf, Strongbow, and Andre, and a whole heap of fans here say this is the right executioner to be in there. Uh-oh, and the executioner in a bit of trouble. Brody making a maneuver. So is the other executioner, but meanwhile, they're just chopping, hacking away. Six wrestlers are in there at one time. Now they're maintaining a little order. Wolf down to the canvas for the cover. Only a count of two this time. Oh my goodness. White Wolf going for the death lock, the leg lock. Cannot get it as a result of interference. Tag made, here comes Jay Strongbow. Attacking Strongbow from behind, just way lazy. Meanwhile, Andre's getting a little piece of something in there also. Tough to maintain order in this six-man match. Andre. With his 400 plus pounds right up on the midsection. The referee has lost any semblance of order. Certainly a value judgment on the part of the referee. Let's get the official word.
Ladies and gentlemen, the time of the third fall, 3 minutes, 10 seconds. Referee Dick Kroll disqualifies the Executioners and Bruiser Brody. The fall goes to Indian Billy White Wolf, Jay Strongbow, and Andre the Giant. They lead 2-1.
Well, as we said before, certainly a value judgment on the part of the referee. Appeared to me that all six individuals were equally guilty of not listening at all to the referee, but nevertheless, it's official. Now, sir, Strongbow, White Wolf, and Andre with a decided advantage. They have one more fall to go if they can pull it off on Brody and the Executioners. Brody unquestionably having an advantage here with Strongbow one-on-one as far as his strength is concerned. And Brody distracting referee Dick Kroll so that Brody's cohorts can go to work on Strongbow. It appears as though they made good use of that tack rope over in the Executioner's corner. They are literally hanging Strongbow over there. Now the rope is from around the neck, but nevertheless, the damage has been done. But perhaps, well, you would think the Executioners and Brody would have a little more respect for referee Dick Kroll after having been disqualified that last fall, but such is not necessarily the case. As we can see here, Brody with, obviously from our vantage point, a big handful of hair. Wild right missing. Strongbow with a chop. However, from behind, the Executioners go to work on Chief Jay Strongbow. And just like that, Brody has a decided advantage. Yelling in the background for Chief to come over and tag. Just about all Jay Strongbow can do right now is to hang in there on his own. Try to get out of that corner. It doesn't look like he's going to do it. Judging from the way Andre came from the far side of the ring, it appears as though his knee is all right. If you recall in the first fall, they really went to work on that knee. Strongbow whipped to the ropes. In the process, tagged Andre the Giant, and here he comes. The Executioner flying to the far side of the ring. Andre scoops him up. Down to the canvas he'll go. Look at this. Oh, my goodness. Andre backing up. Could be over. One, two. Yes, sir. Tremendous crowd on hand, and they're going to leave here, the majority of them, very, very happy, enjoying with Strongbow, Andre the Giant, and White Wolf a victory here in Madison Square Garden over three tremendously aggressive and huge individuals in the Executioners and Bruiser Brody.
Ladies and gentlemen, 4 minutes, 5 seconds, winners of the fall and the match, Indian Billy Whitewolf, Chief Jay Strongbow, and Andre the Giant. Ladies and gentlemen, don't forget, November 22nd, Bruno Sammartino meets Stan Stasiak here at Madison Square Garden. The girls, the midgets, and all the
just about.